You all know the rules. Now, there's a long run down the straight to the winning post the first time, so there's no need to be getting
there for a few years now, to the briefing of the jockeys. Mr Gleeson basically is laying down the law. Last year the running of the Melbourne Cup was very rough indeed, one of the roughest runnings ever, and he's telling them what is expected of them. The eyes of the world are on them internationally, and it is without a doubt the most important thoroughbred horse race they will ride in this country, and as we've said to you, in the world. The 140th running of the Melbourne Cup. And that's what he's telling them, how important it is. Briefing of the jockeys in the stewards' room. Rob Gaylard has a very important presentation for you now.
Thank you very much, Tim. Ladies and gentlemen, if you'd like to just cast your eyes skyward very, very shortly, we will have our skydivers dropping into us here on Melbourne Cup Day. And our Olympic silver medalist in jumping, Jai Tarima, will be probably embarking on the biggest jump of his career so far. But it gives me great pleasure while Jumping Jai descends down here to Flemington. Mike Brady, who wrote the song that Tuesday in November, is here to perform it for us.
Well, we made it through the football, we just survived the show. The cricket's truly with us, and some has struck a blow. But the one event to get you and lift your spirits up is the one they call the Big One. Yeah, it's the Melbourne Cup. That Tuesday in November, we wear our tops and tails. We sit out in the car park, or we push against the rails. From the city to the outback, we wish you best of luck. For the Tuesday in November, when they run the Melbourne Cup. For that Tuesday in November, when they run the Melbourne Cup. We'll be there to catch the big one, we'll be there to watch the show. We'll be there in all our finery, come summer, rain or snow. And if we back a winner, we'll really whoop it up. On that Tuesday in November when they run the Melbourne Cup. On that Tuesday in November when they run the Melbourne Cup. And we'll be there to catch the ladies in bathing suits and gowns. We'll mix the aristocracy with politics and clowns. With one eye on the racetrack, cause our numbers might come up. On that Tuesday in November when they run the Melbourne Cup. On that Tuesday in November when they run the Melbourne Cup.
Do a good job, Mike Brady. Written some terrific songs over the years about AFL footy and many other things. Nice song. The Tuesday in November when they run the Melbourne Cup. You know, the first one was run on the Thursday, believe it or not. Now that changed some years later. 1861 was the first one. Archer, what will happen in 2000? Let's see what might happen in the betting ring. Timothy, what are they throwing on?
Thank you very much, Tim. Well, they are throwing it on Diatribe, number four. Although at this stage, it is 2 points better in the ring than you're getting on the tote. So people sitting at home, you probably want to be on course if you want to get the best price, Diatribe. But it has been the best back runner in the race since the opening of betting following race seven. Far Cry is also in a point. But at the moment, Karpstad Way still the favourite. Freemason's got the drifts. I think they want the track to be a little bit softer for Freemason. Diatribe best backed, and I can tell you the brew down the bottom being kept very safe, Tim Webster.
All right. I tell you, as you walk around Melbourne and go to some dinners and functions, everybody's almost got a different tip for you this year. It's one of the most open races I can remember from that regard. And there's the jockeys being presented to the crowd. That's a time honoured tradition as well. And this is all just terrific. Just terrific. That's Jai Tarima, by the way. Our silver medalist, our long jump silver medalist, Jai Tarima. What a character he is. And getting a big cheer from the crowd. And didn't he have a ball winning that silver medal at the Sydney Olympic Games? There he is, coming in with a skydive. He's the sort of bloke who would just thrill to do that. What tremendous fun. All right, introduction of the jockeys we were speaking of. We had to see Jai first. Here's Rob Gaylard once more.
Thank you very much, Tim. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the riders for the Melbourne Cup here. I'm sure they're a little bit nervous like everybody else is out there. We wish them a safe passage round. I'd ask the boys if they'd like to step forward and salute as we mention their names. The top weight or joint top weight, the man who knows what it's like to win a Melbourne Cup. Aboard the Irish horse in Zelly, Greg Hall. Riding number two, Far Cry. We welcome him out here. Also from Ireland, Far Cry. We welcome Kevin Daly. Arctic Al, number three, will be ridden by David Harrison from Great Britain. Another one of the international raiders to come out here and try and take our cup back. A lot of sentiment goes around today with number four, Dire Drive. His jockey, Jim Cassidy. Number five, Freemason. From the Hawks camp today, ridden by another Cassidy. It's Larry Cassidy. Lightning Arrow. We welcome back to Melbourne on Melbourne Cup Day, Frankie Dettori. Second coming from an outside gate from the Michael Moroney camp. Would you please welcome Michael Coleman. Coco Cabana, one of Gay Waterhouse's representatives here, ridden by a Melbourne Cup winning jockey in Chris Munts. Cuffstead Way. The jockey's wanted to ride him. He's got his chance. Ladies and gentlemen, Damien Oliver. Number 10, Married For, ridden by a very informed Greg Childs. Number 11, behind the smiling Stephen Baster. Yippee-I-O. The winner, of course, of the Mooney Valley Cup, ridden by Darren Beedman. Number 13, Bohemoth, from the Robert Spurden stable. His jockey, Darren Gauchy. Our unicorn, Colin Olson, hoping for a change of luck with him. His rider, a youngster, we wish him good luck, Matthew Gann. Faster Express, number 15, won the cup last year. Can he do it again? Johnny Marshall. Sky Bow heading round for the fifth time in the Melbourne Cup. His jockey this afternoon, Dwayne Dunn. Number 17, Hill of Grace from New Zealand. Talking of riders being informed, ladies and gentlemen, Glenn Boss. Citrus Prince, number 18, a young man who really has taken the overseas world by storm as far as riding is concerned, holding the Australian flag high. Welcome back, Craig Williams. Number 19, Majestic Avenue. A big thrill for a young rider in Aaron Spiteri. Number 20, Mr. Nelson, to be ridden by Jason Patton. Number 21, Prada. The rider here is Lance O'Sullivan. Number 22, Celestial Show. Lenny Beasley takes the mount. Number 23, Maguire, giving a thrill of a lifetime to a young fellow here in Luke Curry. And finally, number 24, the winner of the Saab on Saturday, is Brew, to be ridden by Kieran McAvoy. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the 23 starters in the Cup and their riders, and wish them good luck.
As the jockeys are being introduced to the crowd, in fact, that's it. They head back. Get themselves ready. They'll be tense, that's for sure. They'll be excited because this is the Melbourne Cup, the best race you can win anywhere in the world. We'll welcome the world to the Melbourne Cup on the other side of this break, but we'll take you to this break with another piece of Bart Cummings' genius, the 99 Melbourne Cup of Rogan Josh.
Flemington. From the hallowed turf to the champions of our past, it is a field of dreams. It's where royalty can mix with rogues, and a place where those dreams can come true as if by magic. Australian institution, the Melbourne Cup.
It's unbelievable, I just won the Melbourne Cup!
From across the country and around the world, they've gathered to claim this nation's greatest prize.
To bring this after, Leighton Power in the Arena Stadium, all it's close to me.
From the fashions on the field to the passion in the stands, this is a day like no other.
Champagne and Jezebel.
Stand up and cheer, Australia. This is our finest hour.
What a great finish. That is one of the great finishes in Melbourne Cup history.
Today, the race that stops a nation will stop our hearts as well, along with all the colour and emotion that is the world's greatest 2 miles.
Safely's going to win the Melbourne Cup for Darren Beeple and Bart Cummings.
This is the Foster's Melbourne Cup, live and exclusive to Network 10. To our friends around the world, this is Flemington, Australia's international race course and the grand stage for all the pomp and ceremony that surrounds the running of the Foster's Melbourne Cup for the year 2000. So hello everyone and welcome. Wherever you're watching us around the world, this is Melbourne's finest hour. It's Australia's finest hour. And at 3:20, about 20 minutes from now, when those barrier gates fly open, that roar will be heard around the world. And by, we think, much more than 110,000 people here at Flemington Racecourse. So wherever you're watching us, anywhere in the world, from Dubai to New York City, where we've been right around Australia, welcome to you. Network 10's coverage of the greatest thoroughbred race there is. So welcome to this test of the best. 23 horses, 3,200 metres, separating one of them from joining an illustrious list of 139 previous winners of that three-handled loving cup they all covet, the Foster's Melbourne Cup. Well, all the contenders are now in the mounting yard preparing for the race of their lives. Let's join Peter Donegan and Jenny Chapman for the race of their lives.
Thank you very much, Tim Webster. Hello, everyone. Jenny Chapman, we always marvel at the scene down here in the mounting yard. This year, I think, is even more special.
It's very, very special, Peter. There's no doubt about that. We've got the most beautiful weather. The crowd is enormous here. I've never seen anything like it here in Flemington.
Let's go through the 23 runners, the scratching is Majestic Avenue, and take a look at the overseas raiders first of all. Number one, Enzeli, is to be ridden by Greg Hall, having his 12th Melbourne Cup ride. He won the Cup in 92 on Sub-Zero, trained by John Ox at Kildare in Ireland. The last winner to carry number one was back in 1954, Rising Fast.
Enzeli is a well-performed import and he's a real genuine stayer. When he won the Doncaster Cup, Peter, he did get back, he was up near the lead there and he showed a lot of tenacity, but the only thing is he ran around a little bit. He got blinkers on, he can get his head up. I'm a little concerned about him in the big field here in the Melbourne Cup, but I haven't left him out of the chances.
Number two, Far Cry, Kevin Daly takes his first ride on the Melbourne Cup. The trainer is Martin Pipe from Great Britain. It's 21 years since number two won the Cup. That was Hyperno.
Far Cry has shown just a lot of tenacity in his last couple of outings, Peter. He's got an imposing record over the distance, the 3,200. He's won 4 out of 7 and a couple of placings as well. He'll run out this journey. I think it's a very tough racehorse, and if he's anywhere near the lead on the turn, I think he can go very, very close.
Number three, Arctic Owl, to be ridden by David Harrison, who rode Travel Mate into fifth placing last year, trained by James Fanshawe at Newmarket. It's 12 years since Barrier 21 with Empire Rose in 88.
at the Curra, this horse won the St. Ledger there, and I thought he was given every chance, but he did a pretty good job too with 61 kilos. Gets him at 56 and a half here. From barrier 21, he may be forced to go forward, and if he doesn't, if he has a little bit of luck, he's certainly not out of it.
And the figures that we're seeing as we take a look at number four, Diatribe, are the tote figures and also the Faxon figures surrounding the horse. So on the win tote, $6.20, place tote, $2.40. That horse has drifted out 40 cents, but he is the Caulfield Cup winner. Jimmy Cassidy's 14th ride. George Hanlon's won 3 Melbourne Cups. He's looking to become the 11th horse to complete the double.
A terrific ride by Jim Cassidy in the Caulfield Cup. He got an absolute dream run through there, and that was followed up by a very good run in the Cox Plate behind our champion mare, Sunline. This horse has got the class, there's no doubt about that. Whether or not he can run the distance, we don't know, but the Caulfield Cup form has been very good for the Melbourne Cup.
Number 5, Freemason, the rider Larry Cassidy, his 10th Melbourne Cup ride. He ran third back in 94. John Hawkes has never won a Melbourne Cup. Barrier 2, Jen, has only won the Cup on 2 occasions, and the jockey who did it both times was Larry Cassidy's brother, Jimmy.
Amazing. This horse, he really does look like a genuine 2-miler, that's for sure, and he's been nursed through to this day. He's been well prepared. It was a nice effort in the McKinnon Stakes on Saturday, and I think if he gets the right run, he'll be thereabouts.
Will the Godolphin stable be able to take that famous trophy back to the Northern Hemisphere? With Lightning Arrow, number 6, Frankie Dettori has his 6th ride in the Melbourne Cup. He was runner-up on Central Park last year. Saeed Bin Sarour is the trainer. This horse is the best age for Cup winners. 5-year-olds have won 41 times.
Well, he's been working very well at Caulfield, this horse. I think he'll go forward from barrier 14, and Frankie Dettori rode that front ride last year on Central Park. I just don't know whether he's going to be there at the end. He's only won the 2 races out of 17 starts. He'll give a sight for quite some time.
7 second coming. Michael Coleman has his first ride in the Melbourne Cup for Michael Moroney, one of his 3 runners. The last Derby winner to subsequently win the Cup was Delta, who won the Derby in 49 and the Cup in 51.
Put in a nice effort in the Caulfield Cup. He was running on late. He hooked out wide on the turn there. And he's had 3 runs back in this campaign. He's going to strip a fitter horse going into this. And the distance isn't a problem for him, where it is for quite a few of the other runners in the race. I'll leave him there with a place chance only.
8, the mare Coco Cabana, to be ridden by Chris Munts. Having his 4th ride in the Melbourne Cup, he won on 1998 aboard Jezebel. Gay Waterhouse has run 2 seconds as a trainer. And number 8 has won 3 of the past 13 Cups. Comes from the same gate as Rogan Josh last year.
She won the AJC Oaks over the 2,400 metres this year, and she set it well in the Metropolitan over 2,600, and at the 500 she just kept going too well. I think she's a quality mare, Peter. From barrier 2, she is going to need 22. She's going to need a bit of luck, so I'd say a place chance for her.
Number 9, Karpstad Way. Damien Oliver is a Melbourne Cup winning jockey. He won on 95 aboard Doremus. It's his 11th ride. The trainer is Chris Wood. It says gate 12 there. He comes in one with the scratching, and the most successful barrier in Melbourne Cup history is the one he'll start from.
Very much an eye-catching performance there in the Caulfield Cup. He flew home, he had to go out wide on the turn there, and he's not known over this distance, Peter, the 3,200 metres, but with Damien Oliver on board, I'm sure he's quite confident, or quietly confident, and with 52 kilos, he does get him very well weighted here. He's a good chance on this good track.
Number 10, Maridpore, Greg Childs, the rider, his best, 3rd in 1990 aboard Mr. Brooker. It's his 9th Melbourne Cup ride. Michael Moroney's 2nd stringer here. The last winner from barrier 6, Light Fingers, ridden by Roy Higgins in 1965.
I think Maridpore might just have his work cut out for him here. He did show ability as a young horse in the UK, but he really hasn't fired a shot since he's been here in Australia, and it's very hard for me to tip him.
Behind, number 11, second ride for Stephen Baster. He finished 9th aboard Lay Beale in a Roughhouse Cup last year. Peter Hayes, his father and brother have trained Cup winners. The last winner from barrier 12, Fox Army, 51 years ago.
He bowled home quite nicely on Saturday in the McKinnon Stakes and didn't have any repercussions from that heart scare he suffered in the Moonee Valley Cup. But that has to be a concern, Peter, because he just might not have had the proper preparation for the Melbourne Cup this year. However, he's one of those horses that just keeps running on.
Here is the name that they love to say, number 12, Yippee-I-O, to be ridden by Darren Beedman. His 8th ride in the Cup, he's won 2 in 1990 Kingston Rule, 1996 Saintly. Alan Denham, the trainer. No horse, though, Jen, has ever won the Melbourne Cup from his gate 18.
Well, Yippee-I-O is just racing in great heart. He showed a lot of ability as a young horse, and he's got that back, and I think he's even going better at the moment. With 52 kilos, he'll run out the distance, and I think at the odds, he's probably, well, actually, who's come in quite a bit because he's got a huge fan club, is an each-way chance.
Just reminding you, those wide gates come in one because of the scratching of Majestic Avenue, Bohemian. Darren Gauchy, a 13th ride for him. Will it be lucky 13? He's run second twice on Chagamar and Superimpose. Robert Spurden, the trainer. Only Saintly and Think Big in 1975 have won from gate three.
He won the Adelaide Cup back in May and he looks very well prepared for the Cup distance here today. He bowled home nicely in the McKinnon Stakes on Saturday and he does appreciate the dry track. He's got that here today. I think he's a chance.
Young Matthew Gatt takes his first ride in the Cup aboard 14-hour unicorn for Colin Alderson, the last winner from Barrier 22 as he moves into now Gurner's Lane in 1982.
Our unicorn really hasn't featured in a finish for quite some time and I think he'd have to show some drastic improvement here if he was going to figure in the finish. I just can't see him doing that, Peter, and I'd be prepared to leave him out of the placings.
12 months ago, John Marshall enjoyed his greatest moment in racing when he won the Melbourne Cup aboard Rogan Josh. Today he rides Pastor Express for trainer Paul Cave in his ninth ride in the Melbourne Cup. Let's Elate carried number 15 Saddlecloth to victory 9 years ago.
His last one was in the Moonee Valley Cup and a lot of horses just don't handle that circuit. He's from Sydney, so his form up there has been very good so far this campaign. And I do like the horse. He's a nice horse. I just don't know whether he can get this a strong 3,200 metres. That's a rough place chance for him.
Only one horse has run in more Melbourne Cups than this fellow. His name is Shadow King. This bloke's name is Skybo. Running for the fifth time in the big one today, Dwayne Dunn is the rider. His second ride, the other one was aboard Skybo, trained by Len Smith.
He's an eight-year-old now, and as you said, Peter, the fifth try. A terrible run in the Geelong Cup two starts ago. He was gone a long way from home, and on that run, and probably on his Saab run too on Saturday, it's very hard to recommend him. I'd say at best a place chance for him.
17 Hill of Grace to be ridden by Glenn Boss, ride number six in a Melbourne Cup. He was runner-up on Champagne 2 years ago. Robert Priscott is the trainer, the last winner from Barrier 7, which he moves into backward way back in 1924.
She's a very classy mare. She's only a four-year-old going into the Melbourne Cup here. I thought she just held her ground okay there at Flemington, and I thought the Caulfield Cup run wasn't too bad, but distanced out for her as well.
18 Citrus Prince, the rider is Craig Williams, having his first ride in the Melbourne Cup. Cliff Brown, the trainer, the last winner from the gate this horse will start from, now in from 18 to 17, was at Talak in 86.
He was only beaten one length in the Metropolitan and it is his first go at the 3,200 here. I just don't know that he's quite up to it, Peter. He's running the Caulfield Cup. He was quite well held there, so not for me.
Number 20, Mr. Nelson. Jason Patton's second ride in the Cup for Russell Cameron. Saddlecloth 20, Jen, hasn't won since 1897. That's a fair while ago.
That is a while ago. He was well ridden in the Saab quality on Saturday. I thought he had every chance there. And he's a bit of a wet tracker. He does like the sting out. Of course, he's going to strip a lot fitter here today, but I just don't know whether he's quite up to it on the dry track.
21 Pravda, Lance O'Sullivan's sixth ride in the Cup, second in 85 on Coro Corrie May, trained by his brother Paul. Only one number 21 has won. That was back in 1923, Batali.
This horse worked quite hard towards the first turn in the Caulfield Cup, and she just couldn't go on the last 300 metres. I'm not sure that her form is quite good enough for this, and I'd just leave her there with just a rough place chance.
One of the other roughies, 22 Celestial Show, Lenny Beasley's fourth ride for Len Morton, the last winner from gate 10, Let's Elope in 91.
Had a lot of luck for Celestial Show in the Caulfield Cup, and then fought on okay in the Werribee Cup. This is a lot harder, of course, and just another query for her about the strong 3,200.
23 Maguire, barrier one, it's been 78 years since number 23 won. Luke Curry's first ride in the Cup for John Collins.
He ran third in the Queensland Derby and that's been his best effort in Australia. His battling effort in the Saab was just okay there. He'd probably need to lift his act here.
And the one they've come for, number 24 Brew, there he is. Kieran McAvoy's first ride in the race for Michael Moroney. And it's been a long time, 79 years since number 24 won that sister role of 1921.
Go back two starts for him in the Moonee Valley Cup. He got to the front a bit too early there. And in the Saab, he came out and won. And there's nothing really wrong with his form. Getting him with 49 kilos, he gets in quite nicely. Barrier 24 could pose a problem for him, though.
They are the 23 runners in the Foster's Melbourne Cup. Let's check out what the tote figures are showing around Australia at the moment with massive pearls in excess of $56 million. Dan Malicki, take us through.
Just watching one of the mares, Pravda, has refused to go out. Pete and Celestial Show's playing up pretty badly, so two of the mares are not likening what's going on with them at the moment. Enzelli, $23, number one. Far Cry, $11. $14 Arctic Owl. Diatribe and Freemason, as you would expect, well on the market. Lightning Arrow 22, Second Coming 20, 15 Coco Cabana, 6.40 for Karpstad Way. And then over to Yippee-I-O at $9, has been solid all the way through. Behemoth at 13, one of the major local fancies, $32 for Hill of Grace. And then some of the longer priced horses on the third page, but Brew is one of the most fancied there at $17. The only scratching is number 19, so we're left with a field of 23. Craft are now going out onto the track riderless. Lance O'Sullivan had to jump off, and the clerk of the course is taking her out riderless. Now, Tim Gossage in the betting ring.
Yes, well, they come for one late, and that is Karpstad Way. It's going to jump the favourite quite clearly down here. It's been the best back runner throughout the morning, and right now, Karpstad Way is clearly the favourite. Very good money for the one of the overseas horses, Far Cry. It's shortened 3 points, currently $11.50 on the tote, but in the ring, 3 points shorter. But Karpstad Way will jump the cup favourite in 2000.
So we have two forms of betting here in Australia, the tote and the bookmakers. Tim Gossage brings us up to date with the bookies. There are our selections, Karpstad Way from three of us, Far Cry from two of us, Diatribe from one of us. It is a very open race. They will be racing for this magnificent trophy. There's the rider of Pravda attempting to take that horse down to the gate. The $32,500 trophy is with us. It is the most prized trophy of Australian sport, and it's been won by Vintage Crop in 93, Might and Power in 97. Two of the great horses whose name will be added to the honour roll. We'll find out in a moment when they run the Foster's Melbourne Cup.